Hi friends, today we will discuss about the machine learning life cycle. So what is the machine learning life cycle? So what is the purpose of the machine learning life cycle? So why we have to use the machine learning life cycle? So today this is the topic we are going to discuss. Okay, how does the machine learning system can be work? So machine learning system can be described by using the life cycle of the machine learning. So machine learning life cycle is a cyclic process to build an efficient machine learning project. So the main purpose of the life cycle is to find a better solution to the problem statements. So this is our aim, to find the better solution of the problem statement. So the most important thing in the complete life cycle process to understand the problem statement. So it is known to purpose of the problem. So what is the purpose you have to using the machine learning process? What is the purpose of you have to train the model? What is the purpose of by using the machine learning model? What we are going to make the prediction? So before we going to train the model, first you have to understand a complete data set. And before you have to understand the problem statement, and you have to understand the data set. So what are the features are registered in the given data set? What is the input feature and what is the target feature? So without understanding the problem statement, you can't able to get the good results. So starting the life cycle, we have to understand the problem statement. Because good results depends upon the understanding of the problem statements. So in the complete life cycle process to solve the problem. So here we have to discuss the model. So what is the model? So we create the machine learning system is called the model. We create the machine learning system is called the model. So this is the model is created by providing the training. So but to train the model, we need the data sets. So we need the data set is a life cycle start by collecting the data. So life cycle process is starting by collecting the data. So collecting the data set is the first step of the life cycle process. So in the machine learning life cycle, there are the total 7 steps are existed. So what are the 7 steps? So gathering the data set and the data preparation, data wrangling, analyze the data, train the model, test the model, and deployment model. So we are going to discuss these 7 steps of the machine learning process. So gathering the data. So data gathering is the first step of the machine learning life cycle. So the goal of this gathering the data is to identify the related data. Corresponding to our problem statement. So in this gathering data step, we need to identify the different data sources. So data can be collected from the different kind of data sources, like third parties, like Kaggle is one of the website, and UCI machine learning repository, this is one of the website, and the data glove. So from this data sources, we have to collect the data. And the quantity and quality of the collected data will determine the efficiency of the output. So if you collected the data is more data, our model will be give the good accuracy. If it is take the less data, and accuracy of the model is depends upon the data. If it is less data, it is unable to get that much level of accuracy. So we have to about our problem statement, we have to collect the more data. So in this gathering data, we have to include the 2 steps. So identify the various data sources and collect the data. Next step. So data preparation. In data preparation is the second stage of the life cycle process. So in the data preparation, we have to further this is the second step. Here we have to put our data into a suitable place, and this prepare the data to our machine learning training. So here there are the two steps are divided into processing. So data exploration, data pre-processing. So what is the data exploration? So data exploration is nothing but to understand the nature of the data. So understanding the nature of the data means, so what is the data? So what is the data and what is the shape of the data? So what is the shape of the means the number of the rows and number of the rows and number of the columns. So this is the data set. For example, so here are the four rows, it's the feature 1, feature 2, feature 3, feature 4. So m, so 1 to 5, so 5 by 4, so 5 rows 4 columns. So this is the shape of the data set. So first we have to understand the data set and what are the features. So these are the features types, data types. So data sets means it is a categorical data type, it is a numerical data type. In the numerical data type, it is the integer data type, it is the float data type. So categorical data types can be represented in the form of object. And to better understanding of the data layer, better understanding of the data, it leads to the efficient outcome. And here in data exploration, we are talking about the correlation. Correlation is nothing but the, it is a relationship between the two features. Attributes is nothing but the features. So this is the data exploration. Next step is the data pre-processing. So next step is the data pre-processing of the data analysis. We will discuss about the data analysis in next step. Next, third step is the data wrangling. So data wrangling, it is the process of data cleaning. Data cleaning and convert the raw data into the usable format. So usable format may be data, maybe it is in CSV format and JSONO format, like that. So it is the process of cleaning the data and selecting the variables to use. So among the data set, what are the features is the most important and the target variable. So in real world applications, collecting the data may have the some various issues. So various issues like that are missing values. So suppose what are the data we are collected, some of the data is maybe missing and duplicate data may be existed. So duplicate data can be handled. Duplicate, how can you handle the duplicate means we have to drop the duplicates. That is the only solution. So missing value, number of techniques are existed to handle the missing values. So one of the technique is drop the missing values. Suppose huge data set is available, so at that moment of time, if it depends upon the percentage of the missing data set, we have to drop the data. If it is very less data set we have existed in given the very less data, so dropping is not a solution to handle the missing values. So at that moment of time, we have to go for another approaches. Another approaches means that we have to, instead of the dropping the missing values, we have to fill the missing values. Fill the missing values is nothing but filling the null values. So many techniques are existed to handle the null values. For example, fill with 0, fill with the mean value, fill with the fill, bfill. So these are the so many techniques are existed to handle the missing values. And we use the various filtering techniques to clean the data set. So this is the data wrangling. And next step is the data analysis. So we use the data analysis and visualization techniques at every step of the machine learning process. So every step of the machine learning process means exploratory data analysis is one of the step, data cleaning is one of the step, and model building is one of the step, and present the results is one of the step. So among every step we have to apply the data analysis and data visualization. So before applying any process, any operations, we have to visualize the data, and after applying any operations, we have to again apply the data visualization analysis, how the data is going to be changing. This is the step about the data analysis. Next step, train the model. So before train the model, now data is perfect, ready to train the model. In this step, we have to train our model to improve its performance for better outcome of the problem. So we use the data set to train the model by using the some various machine learning algorithms. Depends upon the data set and the problem statement. If it is a regression kind of data set, we have to use the regression kind of algorithms, suppose the linear regression. And in linear regression, it is the same lasso regression and lasso regression, ridge regression, elastic net regression. So many regression techniques are existed. If it is a classification problem, you can use the support vector machine, decision tree classifier, and logistic regression, random forest regression. So these are the algorithms we have to apply on the data set. Depends upon the problem statement, depends upon the data set. So training model is required. It can be understand the patterns and rules and features. Without pattern understanding, we can't able to make the prediction. Next step is the test the model. So once our model is be trained, once the model is be ready, the model has been applied on the test data set. So what is the purpose of the testing the model? For accuracy of the model by providing the test data set. So accuracy of the model is depends upon the problem statement. Depends upon the problem. If it is regression kind of problem, we can use the accuracy of the model R to score. And some other performance metrics of the regression algorithm is mean absolute error, mean square error, root mean square error. If it is a classification kind of problem statement, we can use the another evaluation metrics like accuracy, score, precision, recall, F1 score, confusion matrix, classification report, ROC curve, AU, ROC score. So these are the evaluation metrics of the classification algorithms. So testing the model determines the percentage of accuracy of the model as per the requirements of the project. Next step, deployment. So this is the last step of the machine learning life cycle in the deployment section, where in the deployment section we have to deliver our model to the third parties. If the above prepared the model is producing the accurate results, as per our requirements with acceptable speed. So within less amount of time, the model has to be give the output. So then we deploy the model in the real systems. But before deploying the project, we have to check the model whether it is improving the performance by using the available data set or not. So the deployment phase is similar to making the final report of the project. So this is the whole life cycle of the machine learning process. I hope everybody will get me understand this concept. Thank you.